We know about similar solar heaters which use mirror strips. These ideas helped me solve the following two problems of this solar water heater for hot water supply of my summer cottage, where the water heater receives solar energy both directly from the sun and from this mirror. The first problem was the fact that this mirror takes up too much space, and I wanted to make it more compact. Secondly, the mirrors can be destroyed by hail or these walnuts. But the biggest danger is this tree with pears, which will be very large in autumn. This is one of the variants for solving those two problems, and it will be described in one of my future videos. And now I am describing the second variant, how I solved those problems. We must note that this large mirror was composed of these three parts, but now I decided to install those three parts one above the other. So, these are the same three parts of that large mirror, but now they take up three times less space, and I can walk between the mirrors and this solar heater. These are three spots of solar radiation from my three mirrors, and we see that the spots join on the surface of the solar heater, because the slope of the mirrors is slightly different. I remind you that my solar heater receives solar radiation both directly from the sun and from those three mirrors. That solar radiation heats up 50 liters of water inside this tank, and for example, now we see that the solar heater increased the water temperature to 71 degrees Celsius. In addition, here we see a roof, which is a protection against hail and these pears. We know that mirrors of the solar heaters must constantly move according to the movement of the sun across the sky. At the same time, my heater and mirrors are located along this west-east line, and therefore they are absolutely motionless from morning to evening. Let's look at how this part of solar radiation from immovable mirrors moves during one day from morning to evening. It is morning, and this part is here, and these are time points during one day of the 6th of July. We see that the spot trying to hit this line all day long, and I remind you that the mirrors are motionless. It is obvious that our solar heater should be here, however we know that this line will change its position day after day, and let's look at how this will happen. So, this is the spot from my mirrors at noon on the 6th of July, but the spot shifted slightly down 10 days later. It is obvious that the spot will shift down day by day, because the height of the sun above the horizon decreases. However, the spot will shift upward until the summer solstice, when the spot position is the highest. We may think that this problem will be solved if we shift our solar heater up or down once or twice a month, but now I will show you two more simple and effective methods of solving this problem. The first method proposes to change the vertical angle of the mirrors, and here I add bricks or pieces of wood to change the angle of the mirrors. Now we can compare the optimal slope of the mirrors in the middle of September and near the summer solstice. The second method of tilting mirrors is based on this screw and this button, and now we see their condition near the summer solstice. But now I show you their condition in the middle of September, and we see that I lowered this button about 8 cm to change the vertical angle of the mirrors. If we use this method, we have such a difference between the mirrors in the middle of September and near the summer solstice. Let's pay attention to the shadow from this roof, and here we see the edge of its shadow. It is obvious that the position of the shadow will be higher if the height of the sun above the horizon decreases. That is why we see here that the shadow shifted up after 1 month, and it will continue to move upwards. Also, the period prior to the summer solstice is the period when the shadow moves downwards. So, the shadow continues to shift up day after day, and one day it begins to fall on our solar heater, and this fact reduces its heat production. Of course, we can avoid the problem of this shadow if we increase this distance between the mirrors and the solar heater, but now I will show you other methods of solving this problem. For example, we can temporarily lift the roof and return it to its original place in a few weeks. Or we can temporarily lift the solar heater and then we will return it to its original place. Or we can remove the roof temporarily for several weeks. However, the simplest method is the right slope of the roof when it is parallel to these rays from the sun. Therefore, the shadow height is minimal and it will be several times smaller if I remove these two white wooden battens. In addition, we must pay attention to these shadows from the mirrors which are located above. And for example, this shadow is created by the edge of this mirror. And the source of this shadow is the edge of the roof. We understand that this shadow slightly reduces the heat production of our solar heater, and we can solve this problem if we increase these distances between the mirrors. In addition, turn your attention to these zones, which are illuminated by the sun and give this additional shadow on the mirrors. These illuminated zones tell us that these battens are not positioned correctly, and I have to install them closer to the center of the mirrors to reduce the size of the shadows. Here we can see the shadows in the morning and evening, and a look from here shows the shadows better. Thus, we understand that the shadows are large in the morning and they gradually decrease until noon, and then they begin to increase. Now I remind you of the size of the shadows at noon near the summer solstice, when the area of the shadows is the largest due to the maximum height of the sun above the horizon. However, now we see the edges of the shadows after a month, when the height of the sun has decreased by 6 degrees. Therefore, we understand that reducing the height of the sun above the horizon noticeably reduces the size of the shadows. These were the shadows at noon, and these are the shadows in the evening of the same day. We see that now the lower mirror has a little shadow here, however the upper mirrors have no shadows.